Hey, racing fans, Jessica here. Happy to be joined by Anthony McDonald of thestable.ca. First and foremost, people don't know what thestable.ca is. Tell us a little bit about what you do.
We try to bring racing to people in the general public. So we'll purchase horses and then offer smaller pieces of those horses up to everybody all over all over the world for the most part. It allows, when you frame horse racing is what it is, entertainment, it's a way to bring very affordable entertainment to really everybody in the world. So it's taking the gamble out of horse racing, so to speak.
You race all over the U.S., in Canada, you dabble a little bit down under as well, but you just mentioned you have clients all over the world. It has to be satisfying to see your product reach that, you know, global.
Yeah, but at the same time, it's our product, isn't it? So when you look at horse racing, you know, what we set out to show and to prove 7 years ago was that everyday people would and did want to get involved in horse racing. And there were a lot of skeptics, right? There were a lot of people that were naysayers or doubters. And really, every time we do good, the industry does good, because it proves for every young or old trainer out there that there's a way forward and there's a way to grow and there's a way to have more than maybe you even thought you could in this industry.
The stable has had such a great year this year on many different states. Can you touch on maybe a few standout performances or horses that you've had this year?
Well, the Colt that's racing tonight, 3-point blue chip, winning the Matron, was obviously a pinnacle of the year for us. We had a lot of luck in Ohio. New York, we had a really nice trotting filly in New York. I mean, we've had luck everywhere. We had our pacing filly in Australia won last night in a new lifetime mark. So it's been a fantastic ride, but it's been a great ride for us, but an even better ride for our clients. And that's what's important, is to, it's not just about winning, but, you know, to show people that horse racing's a lot of fun. It does take winning sometimes, so.
The sale season just got over with. You had a great sale season for this stable. What are you looking for when you go to the sales? What states, sires, gates, female, male? Kind of touch base on that a little bit.
None of it. We're looking for value. And when it comes to any sale, for instance, last year we were able to buy a couple of Walners because he was a first crop sire, and people maybe were a little hesitant to bid on those horses, and that's how we ended up with 3-point blue chip. Now, we did pay a lot of money for him, but when you fast forward a year to his sister selling for $475,000 this year, and looking at him, who we paid $115,000 for, you can see the discrepancy. Yes, he's a colt, not a filly, but at the same time, it has to be about value. We ended up with 6 tactical landing horses this year. And yes, that, I guess it does make the gamble a little bit more, but when you factor in everything all involved, pedigree and confirmation and the horses that you're getting, when you see the horses go for less than what maybe they would for another sire, there's value to be found there. So it doesn't matter whether we go to Ohio, Pennsylvania, New York, New Jersey, wherever, we're always looking to buy the most for the least.
Talk to us a little bit about that colt you do have in tonight in the Valley Victory, 3-point blue chip, a Walner sibling to Plunge blue chip. He bled a little bit in his Breeders' Crown elimination. You supplemented him to the Matron, where he put up a big performance. You had to be happy to see that. What's the word coming into tonight's race?
Jimmy said the horse trained sharp this week. You know, you touched on it. He didn't bleed very much, but if we were realistically going to either look at the Breeders' Crown final or the Matron, you know, both myself and Jason had him in the Breeders' Crown elimination that night. We had talked to the veterinarian here in the paddock, and she made some very good points. She had a thoroughbred background and said that, listen, if you plan, this horse has 4 starts, so it's not like he's been overexerted. She thought that Lasix in this particular case would help. I followed her lead, and we'd spoke to Jason about it. He ended up putting the horse on Lasix. The Matron was at Dover. We had horses with Jimmy there last year. It made sense. We just shipped the horse down to Jimmy, and he was very, very good. James drove the horse incredibly, and we're very fortunate.
Well, we wish you all the best in the Valley Victory. Before I let you go, can you tell us where we can find you on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram?
Anywhere. You can find us on Facebook at The Stable, same as Instagram, Twitter. You can always get a hold of me at anthony@thestable.ca or visit our website. You know, we're always interested to get feedback from people that really maybe don't know what we do or don't have the background in horse racing and go on our website just to see what they think, because really those are the people we're trying to show horse racing, people that know nothing about it. So yeah, visit thestable.ca. You can go to stable.com, but it's like a pottery barn or something, I'm not sure. Thestable.ca, and check us out, because, you know, we have a lot of horses, we have a lot of clients, and we're just trying to get as many people into this industry as we can.
Well, thanks so much for joining us. Best of luck tonight, and best of luck next year.
Thanks very much.